Yes, who wouldn't remember it?
Yes, I do.
Yes, I can recall that is on 20th of November 2014.
Of course, it was the most beautiful feeling. It can never fade away from my memory. I'm sure all of us do. Do you remember?
Well, it was a feeling of mixed emotions.
It was the most beautiful feeling of my life.
The feeling was amazing.
It was a mix of feeling, a bit scared and at the same time happy. One special moment when I was holding her in my arm. So that was the moment. And the incident is, I was first mother, so I didn't know how to hold her and what all I have to do. So that I took it for information from my in-laws.
Special moments. There was the time it was only me and my baby. It was our time.
Special incidents with the baby is when you hold your baby for the first time in your arms. You know, the feeling is like you're touching your baby for the first time. The baby is hearing your heartbeat and you're holding the baby so close like this. I mean, it's just out of the world.
Well, with me, I took some time and feeding the baby, it doesn't come naturally and it doesn't happen instantly. So it took me about a week to form that bond, that connection with the baby.
Very much. Very, very much, I would say.
Very supportive, I would say. Like, while I was feeding, my mother-in-law took the utmost care that I was eating the right thing.
I live into a nuclear family where me and my husband are there. So through the entire journey of my baby, my husband was there with me. He stood by my side always.
My family has been very, very supportive. My husband, my in-laws, my parents, they have been the pillars of strength through all the time.
Breastfeeding is important for mother and baby both, because for mother it's got lots of beneficial effects like quick shrinkage of uterus after delivery, then less blood loss, heavy bleeding is prevented, and it prevents certain long-term undesirable things like breast cancer. Then for the baby it's important because lots of important antibodies are transmitted through the breast milk to the baby, which prevents respiratory infections, and long term it prevents childhood obesity. See, after delivery it's important for the mother to feed as long as possible and minimum for 6 months. Maximum she can feed up to 2 years also. It's more important to avoid smoking and alcohol during pregnancy rather than during breastfeeding, but then if possible the mother should avoid, because as it is, alcohol and smoking are not good for her health. There are no specific tips as such for latching on, but then these days what we have seen is new mothers, they have problems with the latching and normally they give up very soon. It's important for them to persist and persevere with breastfeeding. Initially, all babies will not accept breastfeeding just straight away.
Yes, I did.
Yes.
Yes, I have done.
Yes, I have done.
It was in one of the malls. We went out and you never know when this little creature will be hungry and all that. Then you have to do it.
Airports.
It was a movie theatre.
We believe in one of the ashrams that is in Chhatarpur, so we went there once. So there the custom is that you have to eat the langar over there. So once we were sitting in a queue and I was wearing just western clothes and my child was totally on breastfeed that time. So she was feeling hungry and I didn't carry any stole with me. So I asked my neighbor sitting women for this stone and she asked for it, why are you asking for that? So I told her that my child is hungry and I want to feed her. So she gave me the stone and then I breastfed my child.
People reaction are obviously very awkward.
At first second, I was a little uncomfortable that time because public would it be okay or not? How would people will react to her? So there are a couple of people who just turned around and just looked at me. But they didn't suppress any of their facial expression or anything like that to me. So it's okay.
In the passers-by, the kind of look they give you does make you a little uncomfortable because, you know, they are not comfortable.
One must not be offended or make feel offended on this act. This is a completely natural act, and they must learn, the men out there who inappropriately stare at the woman while doing it, must know how to dissociate the sexuality with the functionality.
I feel quite strange for those people who were staring at me because they were also once breastfed by their moms.
I mean, it's such a pride to be a mother, and when you have to, you are a mother, then I don't think so. When you can give a birth, I would say that, you know, when you're giving a birth in a labor room, there are 10 people around you, female and male staff. Why don't you say that, you know, you should be ashamed by giving a birth? But when you're not that, when you're not ashamed of that, why breastfeeding?
The mother doesn't feel sexy about breastfeeding. If somebody thinks it's offensive and vulgar, it's the minds that are corrupt, and that needs to be, you just need to work on your own thinking and not stopping women from breastfeeding in public.
A lot of people feel awkward or shy, but we must encourage the young mothers to not be awkward about it. It's a very natural thing. You should feed your baby whenever the baby is hungry, wherever the baby is hungry.
See, the baby will not understand whether the child is in public or at home. If the baby is hungry, at that moment he needs his mother. So the mother should never be ashamed to breastfeed a child in public.
That's the thing to be learned from the villagers. Villagers, they never shy, you know, in feeding in public. Dekha hoga na, the rural ladies hoti kahi bhi niche baith jayengi, kahi bhi baith ke stations pe dekha hoga, railway platforms pe, footpaths pe, no question bhi lagti, because breastfeeding is a physiological thing.
I think to sensitize people, it is very, very much needed to sensitize their mindset, you know, their mentality towards a woman and especially a mother.
We need to change the mindset of the society on the whole. Apart from the men and the family and the older generation supporting, I think we need to change the mindset of the new generation as well.
Society has the mindset that they don't allow their women to breastfeed publicly. So to me, my child comes first, and I don't care what the society thinks. My motto is to feed my child first.
I think for people's mindset to change, we have to encourage the young mothers who are feeding the children to, you know, to encourage them and tell them that it's not a shameful thing. You must go out. If you go out in public, you can feed your child, and we must create awareness.
Grandparents must understand that they must have gone through similar situations in their past, and they must educate their sons or the men in the family to support their ladies. In the morning, we have to get her ready for her school. So I give her a shower, she packs her lunch, and by the time she's doing her bit, we are ready for school. I'll share a very funny story with you. Like, we were on a lunch date, and that was our first lunch date after my daughter was born, and we took her out and she wanted food for herself before us. So my wife was a little reluctant in doing that, and I literally had to force her to do that because the baby is hungry. And that's what you do when the baby is hungry, you feed her, regardless of where you are.
As a fashion stylist, there are a few tips that I'd like to share. In today's busy lifestyles, I think we should be smart enough to, first of all, be very comfortably dressed. Natural fabrics like cottons really help, because it depends, no matter where you are in a country like ours, where we have all sorts of seasons, we are blessed with the wonderful seasons here, whether it's summers or humid weather, rainy or winters. Any natural fabrics like cottons really help. Then we can smartly layer it up. You can always carry a piece of cloth with you, like it could be a scarf or a shawl, because you might just need to feed in public. So always carry something with you, like a scarf or a shawl, so you can just throw it up on your shoulders and comfortably feed your baby wherever it is needed, whether it's in public or in the comfort of your home or friends' places or wherever. Or you have your family members around where you might not be very comfortable. So it's always smart enough to carry a piece of cloth with you. Then always layer up. You can wear a proper tank top or a vest, full vest, and wear a comfortable top over, so you can wear wherever they need be. You can pull up your top and then pull down your vest or the tank top, and you're still very well covered with your baby comfortable as well. Thirdly, one can wear tops with which probably are again layer up with a very comfortable top where you can have very well cut from the sides, where you can just pull it, you know, on the side, and you are again easily fit with another layer of top over it.
People will have their views, no matter good or bad, whatever you may do.
I think why it would be shame?
No, definitely not. There's no shame in it.
It's no shame for me.
Well, I think definitely it's a no shame, and one should not be ashamed of feeding a child in public. The child is hungry and the child wants food, then he must get it.
Not at all shame. Why shame?
Probably you can do it too.
I did it. You can too.
When I can do it in public, the breastfeeding, why can't you?
All the housewives sitting in their house, come and share the experience with us.
I share my experience. Mommies, you can share your lovely experience too.
All the mothers, come and share your experience with us.
So moms, let's relive our moments and share the experiences.
So all the honeys, come and share your experience with us.